either. Today, we're going to be talking about ways in which we can answer this question. ¿Cómo estás? Which means, how are you? In previous videos, we already saw this, but we stuck to pretty basic answers, such as estoy bien, estoy mal, which means I'm good or I'm not good, I'm not doing well. But there's so many more things that we can say, and that's what we're going to be talking about today. And what I've done is that I've divided the board into two parts. The first one goes with answers that have the verb estar. And as we said, the verb to be in English has two different translations in Spanish, which are ser and estar. And I will be making a video explaining what the differences are and when we use one, when we use the other. But today, let's just remember that estar is followed when we want to say how we're feeling at a specific moment in time, okay? So we want to say things like, I'm tired, I'm happy, I'm disappointed, I'm excited, I'm angry. Then all of those are going to go with estar, okay? And then the second side of the board has answers that have the verb tener, to have, okay? And I'll get to those in a sec. So let's get started with this ones. ¿Cómo estás? How are you? We can say things like, I'm good, I'm not good, estoy bien, estoy mal. Also, I'll be putting the conjugation of both verbs on the board just so that you have them. But there's many more things we could say. We could also say, estoy contento. And if you're a girl, you say contenta, okay? I'm happy, I'm in a good mood, estoy contenta, okay? If we want to say, I'm in a good mood or I'm in a bad mood, we could say, estoy de buen humor, I'm in a good mood, or estoy de mal humor, I'm in a bad mood, don't talk to me, okay? Estoy de buen humor, estoy de mal humor. Awesome. So, contento, contenta, happy. Then we also have triste. Triste means sad, and the ending is going to stay the same for both male and female, okay? So, if you want to say, I'm sad, or I feel sad, estoy triste, okay? Then we also have enojado, enojado, enfadado. Those mean mad, angry, to be mad. You're going to say enojado, enojada, enfadado, enfadada. So estoy enfadado, estoy enfadada. Awesome. We also have cansado, cansado. That means tired. And if it's female, if it's a girl, cansada. And if it's more than that, if you're not just tired, but you're exhausted, then you're going to say agotado, agotada, okay? Estoy agotada, I'm exhausted. Estoy agotada, okay? Good. Then we also have enfermo. Enfermo or enferma, if you're a girl, means to be sick or to feel sick, to feel ill. Like you feel like you're coming down with something, you don't feel quite right, okay? Or you have a fever. That means, okay, estar enfermo. And to get more specific, imagine you're feeling dizzy. That's what this means, mareado. So in my case, if I were feeling dizzy, I would say, estoy mareada. I'm feeling dizzy. If someone asks you how you're doing, then you say, no estoy bien, okay? No estoy bien, I'm not doing good, I'm not doing well. No estoy bien, estoy mareada, okay? Good. Then we have emocionado, emocionada. That means excited. When you're excited to do something, estás emocionada. You're excited about something. Good. Decepcionado, decepcionada. That means disappointed, okay? So quite the opposite of excited. Decepcionado, disappointed, okay? Good. Asustado, estar asustado means to be afraid, to be scared. Tener, okay? Miedo, which we'll see in a sec. Estar asustado, estar asustada. Awesome. Then we have estresado. This one is quite similar to English because in English we say to be stressed out or to feel stressed out. Okay? Estresado. And again, if you're a girl, estresada. And this one here is quite similar. Agobiado, agobiada. It's also stressed out, but it also means overwhelmed. So it's a mix between those two. You feel stressed out, you feel overwhelmed, you have too much on your plate. Estás agobiado. Okay, good. Motivado, that's motivated. When you're really feeling like doing something and you have all these new projects that you want to try and you want to take up. So, motivado. And the opposite, demotivated, would be desmotivado. We're adding that prefix at the beginning of the word. Desmotivado, desmotivada, okay? And then sorprendido, sorprendido, sorprendida. That means surprised or in shock, okay? Surprised, when you didn't expect something. So all of these ones go with estar, okay? To be. Estar triste, estar alegre, estar contento, estar cansado. All of those. And then, so sorry, before I move on to that one, just so that you know, all of these ones, obviously, they're adjectives. So estar is followed by adjectives. Tener is going to be followed by nouns. All of these ones are nouns, okay? So in English, we would still use to be. So for example, this one would be to be hot, to be cold, to be hungry, to be thirsty, and to be scared. But in Spanish, we're not going to be using this one, okay? Which is one of our translations for the verb to be. We're going to be using tener, which is, literally means to have. So for us, all these expressions would literally mean the following. Tener calor, to have heat. Tener frío, to have cold. Tener hambre, to have hunger. Tener sed, to have thirst. Tener miedo, to have fear. That's what they literally mean. But of course, no. When we say, when in Spanish we say, tengo calor, that's, oof, I'm hot. Okay, it's too hot in here, I'm hot. Tengo calor. Or if I say, tengo frío, of course, it doesn't mean I have cold. It means I'm cold. Tengo frío. Turn the heat up. Tengo frío. Okay? I'm cold. Tengo hambre. I'm hungry. Okay? You haven't eaten and you're starving. Tengo hambre. I'm hungry. Tengo sed. I'm thirsty. Okay? Y tengo miedo. I'm scared. So that's another way of saying estoy asustada. Tengo miedo. Okay? They both mean the same. Awesome. Well, guys, I hope this was helpful. Please remember to, oh, I dropped the cap, that's fine. Please remember to subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for upcoming videos. And let me know if you have any questions, as always. Thank you so much, guys. Bye.